This video is a beginner's guide for ComfyUI, a stable Diffusion user interface. We will be looking at what is ComfyUI, pros and cons of ComfyUI, installation, downloading extra resources, understanding the interface, generating an image. As said previously, ComfyUI, a stable Diffusion user interface. For people who are new to programming, let me explain where it stands in the process of image generation. If you write a prompt, a flying dog, the Python-based program downloaded from GitHub will process and send the instructions to the CPU, GPU. Load the necessary stuff in your 16 or 32 gigabytes of RAM and will use the large stable Diffusion files to generate the output. Further, sending images to the browser. There are multiple such interfaces like Automatic 11, Focus, and others, which uses the hardware and large stable Diffusion files to generate an image, each with their pros and cons. Let's look at the pros and cons of ComfyUI. No coding experience is required. I had installed ComfyUI, and with a click, I am generating some nice image. Working with ComfyUI is fast and flexible. We have lots of options to customize as per our needs. It gives clarity by having the entire work process in front of us on a single screen. Also, while generating image, we can see the workflow of this nodes highlighted in green border. The workflow visible here can also be shared across ComfyUI users, which can save some time and effort. The node here can be dragged and positioned as per our needs. However, having such option adds up into a disadvantage as well, like different structure of every individual users. Options to customize also require knowledge and learning. Complex structure can also result in performance issues. Let's look at the installation process. I will be installing on Windows. For Mac, I will be making a separate small video because I do not have a Mac. I may get it from someone. We are lucky to have a standalone installable file. It's for those who want to avoid all the complex errors and just get it started. Save the file and extract after the download is completed. You will have an extract option like this or else. You can download 7-zip or WinRAR to extract. When you open the extract folder, you will find folders and files. You will also find a README file. Opening the file in the notepad, you will see instructions given for ComfyUI. Run NVIDIA GPU BAT file if you have a NVIDIA GPU, else, run on a CPU which will be slow. It also says about a red error. If we do not download a checkpoint, below is the download link given for the checkpoint. What's the checkpoint, you may ask? The large stable Diffusion file here is the checkpoint, which can be used by ComfyUI or any other stable Diffusion UI you will be working with. As per instruction, let's run the NVIDIA BAT file. The program will run, and the output will be visible in the command prompt. As you can see here, it will open the browser, and an instance of ComfyUI will be loaded like this. If we try generating an image using QPrompt, you will see an error like this. The error message may be different, because I intentionally made this error to show you. This is the red error mentioned in the README file. To fix this, let's download the extra resource necessary here. As said in the README file, to download the checkpoint, copy the link and paste in the browser. You can download the file by clicking this download text. However, the best source of checkpoint I prefer is Civit AI. There is an option for models. This will show us all the checkpoints available. You can sort it based on ratings and apply filters like month, year, or best of all time. Model type for us is checkpoint. Common base models are SD 1.5, SDXL, and the new SD3. You can also select the file format above as a safe tensor. If we click on one of the checkpoints, we can see there are multiple versions of the checkpoint. This button is to download this file. Before downloading, we should check the base model here. You can also identify by the XL suffix in the name of the model. As said, common models are SD 1.5 and SDXL 1.0. So, what's the difference? When it comes to processing power, SDXL has a significantly higher base parameter of 6.6 billion, outperforming SD 1.5, 3.5 billion. This enhanced capacity enables SDXL to handle more complex data with ease, resulting in high-quality images that require minimal prompting. One of the most notable advantages of SDXL is its ability to generate images with a resolution around 1024 pixels, whereas SD 1.5 is limited around 512 pixels. Furthermore, SDXL offers improved training speed for custom LoRA, allowing users to fine-tune their models more efficiently and achieve better results. SDXL needs approximately 8 GB of graphic memory, which may not be possible in most use cases. SD 1.5 becomes a correct choice in such scenarios. However, some interfaces like Automatic 11 have optional parameters like low VRAM. ComfyUI is already optimized for low VRAM, hence you can try using XL models. For this example, I will download SD 1.5, assuming most viewers prefer it. Let's try Dream Sheppa. As said in the README file, save the checkpoint inside ComfyUI folder, models, then checkpoint. It may take some time to download. Next we need is ComfyUI Manager. This is something that does not install automatically. In the installation section, the second method of installation here looks for the portable version of ComfyUI, which involves downloading a .bat file, then just click to install in the ComfyUI directory. Well, I was expecting a .bat file to be downloaded. However, it just gave me the commands to install the manager. It says here, download .bat file to ComfyUI directory, then click to install. Let's create a .bat file, go to the ComfyUI folder. Create a copy of an existing Windows batch file. To keep it similar, copy the .bat file name from GitHub and rename the copied .bat file. Open the newly created .bat file using a notepad. You will find the old instructions, remove the instructions. Copy the instruction from the GitHub and paste the same in our new .bat file for manager, then save. You have created a .bat file with instructions for your computer. Double-click to run. I skipped the installation part, now it's installed. Let's restart ComfyUI. As you can see, the manager option is not there. Control plus C to stop the ComfyUI instance. And it's stopped. Now, start again. The ComfyUI manager has been installed. And these are the options in the manager. Let's understand the interface. So, this is the interface or workflow we should be looking at. If your workflow looks different, click Load Default. We downloaded the Dream Sheppa checkpoint. I had Juggernaut XL for learning. If you don't find your checkpoint here, you must click Refresh, and it should be visible. If it's still not there, then there's some problem. You need to check the file if present or not in the checkpoint folder. If the text or model name is overlapping, you can easily adjust the node size by clicking and dragging the node from the bottom right corner to enlarge it. These are nodes, connected to each other. We can call it a workflow. It may look a bit complicated. Let me explain this by making it a bit simple. So, all the boxes you see here are a node. Even this, with parameters. This case sampler is a node, having three parts, left, center, and right. We should consider these parts as input, data taken by node. Output, that is, data given by node, and these parameters are the values expected from the user to manipulate and get the result. Case sampler node deserves a separate video of its own. This is a checkpoint node, which does not require any input information. However, it needs the checkpoint to be selected. And this is the output that goes to other nodes responsible to perform their task. Every node has specific functionalities, and to perform these functions, it requires input or some kind of information. This node is responsible for the height or width of the image to be generated. Also, we can specify the number of images to be generated in this workflow at once. This is the text encode node, having all three parts. Information is sent from right as output, and expecting some information in the center from the user. Similarly, the other text encode which became the negative prompt, because if goes and connects the K-sampler's negative prompt socket. The K-sampler nodes take information from multiple nodes, making it the heart of our workflow. This is where all the recipes are combined on a set proportions to generate a perfect image. I attempted to provide a brief explanation of each parameter, but I realized that the technical terminology might be challenging for non-AI experts to understand. Therefore, I decided to remove the explanation and instead create a separate video that demonstrates the results of tweaking these parameters, making it easier to comprehend. K-sampler finally sends information to the VAE node and further goes to the last, save image node, which saves the image in a folder name output, inside ComfyUI folder. Let's generate an image. Also, we will go through the option on the right side of the UI. The image got generated. It was quick. But what actually happened? When I clicked the Q prompt, it took the entire workflow, including these nodes, the entire workflow, and was sent to the backend. ComfyUI sends the entire workflow to the backend with the values we selected to process and generate the image to display. Below we have a checkbox named Extra Options. If checked, we see a field named Batch Count with the default value 1. If I increase the count by 1, this will take the entire workflow to the backend twice in a queue. Let me show you in the history log, I will clear this. And submit. We got two images in our history. If I increase the batch size in the node, and then submit. Now, there are four images in history. Two older. And other two are new. We generated four images in a single click by sending two workflows in a queue to the backend. This is the slider to increase the batch count. There is another checkbox for auto queue, which gives us options named, instant, and change. It looks like the auto queue function has some error. I also checked on Reddit, and it has been discussed about images kept on generating. If we select the other option named change, it is supposed to add the workflow in the queue whenever there is change in the graph or any values in a node. As you can see, I changed the steps from 19 to 18, and after this change, it keeps on generating, that is adding workflow in the queue. If you uncheck the option auto queue, image generation stops. Next, we have an option called Q prompt. This feature allows us to prioritize our workflow by adding it to the front of the queue, ensuring it is executed before all other existing workflows. The extra option checkbox enables two features: real-time image getting updated and bulk image generation. This suggests that the ComfyUI is designed to be server-ready, making it suitable for mass production, and is likely to have robust memory management capabilities compared to other similar applications. We also have an option to view the queue. It shows the current running queue and the pending workflows behind it. You will see the queue size here. I also saw a delete option in the queue to remove work from the pending queue. The save option allows us to save the workflow. We can save our preferred workflow in a folder for different types of projects. I will create a folder in ComfyUI folder. And now, it is saved. The load option allows us to load the workflow we have saved. The refresh option allows us to refresh the files we manually add, like a new checkpoint added in the folder will appear after refresh. ClipSpace gives a message that it's empty, because we have not copied an image into it. Let me generate an image to copy. Now, there is an image into ClipSpace. We have a tool to select the image, mask, and edit it further. I will be showing in the future video. It sends the image from ClipSpace to the node to process it further. The clear option clears the entire graph, and the next option, load default, brings the default workflow to the graph. The reset view option brings the workflow at the center of the screen. Manager, we installed by creating a bat file, has a lot to offer. It needs a separate video of its own. The share option lets you share the generated image on some of the platforms where people post their creative works, discuss, and connect. I have not done this, but it's common where you have to sign in on this website and get your API keys, paste the key, and the image will be shared on the platform via API. This was my first video on ComfyUI workflow. I'm still learning, also trying to share with others. It was quite an effort to express thoughts and ideas through video. If the video was helpful, a like will be great. Stay connected for more videos.